Hey everyone, it's Ryzen, and welcome back to Let's Play Summoner. Well, we're going to be leaving town and doing some things on the world map, unfortunately. Okay, here we are on the world map. Now, I'm going to explore the world map first, just to unveil it all while I'm looking for encounters. There is a checklist in the video description of every encounter that you will want. Some of them just have items that I don't plan on using, so you could skip those. Like, I think there's one that has a katana of skill that's not very good. But, yeah. There's a lot to do. Now, unfortunately, the encounters are all called Orenia, day or night, which is annoying. So I have listed what kind of enemies you find there. Like, there's a grasslands encounter at night that has some gargons, and you can find Death the Cat there. Oh, ironically, I found it. But I don't need to talk to this cat right now. Well, actually, I wonder if I can pick up the chest, or the quest from him. Let's find out. I want to summon the... Well, I would summon the Celestial Samurai, but no, these guys kind of ambushed me. Did Rosalind get paralyzed? Yeah, she did. Yeah, there's a greater Gargon here as well. He's just a more powerful Gargon. He's still weak to blunt attacks. And he can unfortunately paralyze you fairly effectively. And you cannot trip the Gargons like before, unfortunately. I will not be doing a whole lot of fighting on screen in this episode, I don't think. Because there's a lot to do. Good, he's dead. Okay, Death the Cat. Let's talk to him. How about you guys go in solo mode, just so nobody aggro somebody. So, yeah, apparently this cat is a demon or something, I don't know. Who's Along? Some guy's telling jokes, huh? Oh. You just believed the guy you're chasing. Whatever. Okay. Well, we'll have to find Along. There's nothing else in this encounter. You don't have to talk to Death the Cat until we have something to give him, which is not for a while, but yeah, let's get out of here. Okay, here we are. Back on the world map. Let's keep exploring. I'll be going to the map a lot to make sure that I get everything. My kitten is on my leg. She's playing with the timer. No, she's not. She's sitting on the table. I don't know what she's doing. She almost fell off the table. Now she's sitting on the summoner game case. That is kind of ironic. Okay, that was just another Death the Cat. Because why not, I guess. Just don't enter Liangshan. It's to the east, I think. Yeah, it's all the way in the east. There's nothing in the western side of the continent. Okay, so here's an encounter with a bunch of soldiers. I don't care about this one. There's nothing here. Just head for the exit. Gotta watch out for that samurai guy. He's going to inflict slow on you. But you should be able to make it out. There we go. Okay, let's keep going. Well, let's keep making saves here. Just so that, you know, random counter doesn't screw me over here. Yeah, there's nothing on the western side of the continent, like, at all. Which is very odd. There's nothing in the north, either. It really feels like Orenia got butchered. Okay, we got a nighttime encounter with some Rockools. This is where we can find the Sparrow's Egg. And you want to try and get this one quickly here. Yeah, we got red Rockools. I will list... I guess I'll copy and... I think I had a bestiary of all the enemies that you can encounter on the world map, so that'll be in the video description. Now, I don't know exactly where this encounter is. It's... or where this item is. I think it's over here. I imagine these guys are weak to ice, the red Rockools. Let's summon. Of course. I don't think you can trip these guys either. I forget. Oh no, these are the Rockles are the same guys as like the Crystal Rockles. They're just a little stronger, I would imagine. They're probably weak to energy. Yeah, red Rockles, they're immune to fire and ice. They're actually immune to ice. They're vulnerable to pierce, of all things. And the regular Rockles, they're vulnerable to pierce as well. So they're a little different than what we're used to. There's also sand Rockles, but they don't have a weakness. They're just resistant to fire. But they're not around here. Just gotta find this Sparrow's Egg. That's a Ring of Dexterity. That's not what I'm looking for. I remember it being in the grass somewhere. If I need to, I'll edit out to find it. Yeah, why don't I just do that? I will edit out till I find the damn thing. Okay, I found it. If I can pick it up. Here it is, the Sparrow's Egg. Yeah, it's just a plant. And that's the only thing that we can find in this encounter. I'm gonna get the hell out of here. And we're gonna hand that into Nandi immediately. Because I need to hand in the Sparrow's Egg to get the Gimati's cloak to show up, which is the next item in the chain. Okay, so, unfortunately, let's go back to Wolong immediately. Hopefully I do not find an encounter with Oni enemies during, what is it, at night? It's during the day. That was just more soldiers. Unfortunately, that seems to be a very common encounter, and there's nothing to do there, which is really stupid. Okay, we're back in Wolong. Now, if you found Ahlong in a daytime grasslands encounter, come over here, talk to this guy, pay 1,000 gold, and he'll tell you what to do next. Unfortunately, it will require going to Liangshan, and we're not going to be doing that for a while. You do need to talk to him before going to Liangshan, though, and finding Ahlong, before he'll actually tell you what to do next. But yeah, give her the Sparrow's Egg, and now we need Gimati's cloak. You can find the encounter with Gimati's cloak, but I believe Gimati's cloak will not appear. What the hell was that? Oh, it's two dogs. That looked kind of weird graphically, but whatever. So let's get out of here. Okay, so... oh, I should mark off that I got that one done. That could be... annoying if I forget which ones I've done. The deserts have different encounters. I don't know if that counts as a desert, I forget. Luckily, this isn't like the forest thing in Medeva. It's pretty easy to find you know, either the grass or the desert here. Oh, we are in a desert encounter. I did not expect that. But okay, this is actually an encounter that I wanted. I think. Is it? I don't know. Oh. So you guys came from Medeva. Anyway, we want to talk to Kanji over here. Yeah, there's nothing out to find here. But, I want to buy two Debassers. One for Joseph, one for Jekhar. So let's go ahead and do that. That's why I needed to have like 120,000 or so gold coming into Chapter 2. But anyway, the Debasser is the best weapon in the game, period. It has the highest attack power of any one-handed mace. It's a relatively fast weapon. And it causes trip relatively, effectively. It triggers quite often. So, yeah, it's an amazing weapon. Definitely the best weapon in the game. You want to pick that up. I don't think he has anything else that's really interesting to buy. No. Buy a breastplate. Why would you ever do that? If you didn't get the Swordsman's Torque, you could buy that here, or the Scutum Shields, but I already got that. I want to equip that stuff right away. The Debasser is incredible. I also went ahead and re-equipped the crossbow onto Rosalind there. If you don't have enough money for it, I guess you could just get one if you can afford that and pass down the Impaler. And then later on, you'll be able to sell something that'll solve almost all your money problems. But for now, shouldn't be too bad. I forget if there's actually enemies in this encounter. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. Let's get out of here. That's probably the most important encounter to find. That's the only place you can buy that weapon, I believe. Yeah. Although you can get it as a drop later on, but not until near the end of the game. Okay, so let's keep exploring the Orenian continent. So apparently that counts as a desert area. I thought it did, but I couldn't quite remember. Oh, another encounter. Okay, so here we're in a nighttime desert encounter with, I think, undead enemies. Now here's some imps. I don't know if that's a good sign or not. No, I think this is just a bunch of imps. Yeah, because there's black imps over there. This encounter has nothing to it. We've already fought fire imps, but there's other imps in here. There's black imps, I think. The funny thing is, you can't fight blue imps, but black imps can silence you. And they're strong against fire, ice, energy, and pierce. Vulnerable to slash. Oh, here's one right here. So yeah, for this encounter, just get the hell out of here. They can drop medallions of night, but yeah, I don't think they're that useful. Let's just get out of here. There's also green imps that can poison you. There's an exit right there. Yeah, green imps, they're vulnerable to pierce. But yeah, they can poison you. Okay, keep exploring. I like to explore the world map while I'm doing this so that, you know, I have to do less what feels like farming. This is the desert region, which I'm gonna guess the Ring of Four Winds was gonna be in this desert region, like it seems like there should have been a dungeon up here, but there's not. So we got a daytime desert encounter with some sand rockles, it looks like. And sand minotaurs as well. Yeah. Now this one, I want to do some farming. I want to farm the sand rockles for a ring of slaying. It should not be very difficult to do that. So just save, kill all the sand rockles if I don't get the item. Oh. There's Orenian soldiers? No, I think there's still sand rockles here. Yeah, there they are. So I'm gonna farm these three over and over and over again until I get a ring of slaying. It's a common drop, if I remember right. There's also Aug mages over there. I think this is actually a slightly different encounter than the one I normally get that also has sand minotaurs. But the sand rockles will get the job done here in this encounter as well. Speaking of the sand rockles, they're just vulnerable to pierce attacks, if I remember right. Where the hell are they? Well, the sand minotaur... Oh, I heard something drop. No, I didn't get it. But the sand minotaurs, they're strong against fire. They don't have a weakness. Aug mages, which are those guys over there in the red, they don't have any strengths or weaknesses like pretty much every typical... Let's just reload here. Every typical Orenian soldier. But they can drop a fell staff, so if you didn't get one earlier, you could get one for free there, but it's kind of pointless now. Ah, there we go. Sand rockles. They're strong against fire. They don't have a weakness. There's also some undead enemies that are all the same, except for a new one called a mummy that can curse you. And it's immune to energy, weak to fire and ice. Has a lot of HP. And then there's Oni enemies that we can encounter, but we haven't found any yet. Okay, so we'll try this one more time on screen, and then if I don't get it, I will farm them. I think sand minotaurs can actually drop something interesting, I forget. Yeah, they can drop a saber halberd or a defender heater. Nothing too critical, but there, I guess. I want the Ring of Slaying for Flece, by the way. It ups her backstab by 3. It's really good for her. And that's why I don't need to up her backstab beyond 7. Unfortunately, it means that Flece has 3 rings that I want to use. Does she actually have her 3 rings right now? Or her 2 rings right now? I forget. Yeah, she's got the Ring of Thieves. No, she does not yet. But she will in the near future. So I'll just have to keep subbing in the Ring of Thieves at that point. No? Okay, I'll be back when I get the damn thing. Okay, so I should have it here. I just have to pick this lock.
Success.
Did I get 2 of them? Yeah, I must have.
Success.
It's the only item they drop. So let's go ahead and equip it. You have to identify it. Make sure you do it in the map, or in the random encounter itself, because if you try to identify on the world map, it doesn't work. One of those weird bugs. I think I have to identify that icy dagger, yeah. Alright, so take a look at Fleece's attributes now. She's got 10 sword weapons, 10 backstab. Now, going over 10 backstab actually does make it more powerful, but frankly, at that point, you know, it's, for all intents and purposes, overkill. Okay, let's, keep exploring here. Yeah, we got a little spot right there that we gotta get. Okay. There's more desert encounters to get, but there's also grassland encounters still to get. Okay, I think we actually found a desert encounter that I care about. We got some besides here, but I don't care about that. That should be Tathel the Wanderer, I believe. Yeah, that guy should be for a quest. Get a Besite Tail. That I don't need. Yeah, Tathel the Wanderer. Remember this guy that we was mentioned way earlier in the game in Iona? Yeah, we can finally complete this quest. Sounds rough. Yeah, sounds really rough. Jeez. So what did you do? Yeah, did you know Bilan? Well, here's Bilan's scroll that we got from that monk way earlier. Yeah. For some reason, you have to do this quest in order to get this dragon scale, which means you have to complete this quest that you can't access in Chapter 2, so you have to have already accepted it in Chapter 1 in order to complete a quest that you get in Chapter 2. That seems very weird to me. Whatever. Quest is gone now. As you can see. Now, that blue dragon scale, let's see what that does. It's not very useful. Yeah, it's ice plus 2. I don't care about it. But anyway, there's a... Oh, where's that item? Right here. We get a ring of grounding. That gives you energy resistance that I don't care about. I'm not going to use it. But there's another other... There's another other... There's another item that we can get here. This is the only encounter that you can find some besides. Kind of strange, but... It's probably right over here. There is sand rock... Or no, it's just normal rockles. Okay. No? There's not very many enemies in this encounter, so... Should be able to avoid most of them here. There's a piece of armor that I want to pick up here. I just don't quite remember exactly where it is. I suppose I should edit out until I find it, huh? Yeah, I'll give it another minute after I take out this guy. By the way, the Debassers cannot trip an enemy that is immune to trip. But again, there aren't very many enemies left in the game that are immune to trip. Typically, they're found on the world map, actually. Is that a sand rockle? No. Nope, I'll be back when I find it. Okay, I found it. Oh, right. I can't. Yeah. It's the Mellifuous or Mellifuous Scoh. Whatever, they're better boots for Rosalind, so let's go ahead and equip them. I think they have the same defense, yeah. They just have slightly better magic defense. It's plus 2 instead of plus 1. So let's go ahead and equip them. Let's take a look at what her magic resistance is now. 83%. Not bad. But yeah, it's right by this rock hole. And there's Tathel in the background, so hopefully you can kind of figure out where it is from there. I believe that's the only other item here. Yes. Yep, that's it. Definitely want to pick up that Mellifluous Scoh, those boots, whatever. I don't know how to pronounce it. For some reason, I always have an easier time getting the desert encounters that I want. I don't know why. In fact, there's only one more desert encounter that I care for. It doesn't have anything particularly useful, but for the sake of completion, I do want it. It's a nighttime encounter with some undead enemies. Oh, yeah, I should save. Because I got all those items and I don't want to have to get them again. This will be a long episode, as I figured it would. Should be back in the grasslands region. I'll go back to the desert region for that last encounter later. Okay, let's keep going. That was just a battle with more soldiers, of course. Yeah, these mountain areas don't have any new encounters. I don't think I can get that little piece there. Ah, here we go, Alang. I was looking for this guy. You need a joke or a riddle to save your life? Oh, you're pursued by that cat. That's right. We heard about that. So, why don't you just keep doing that? So you need another joke or a riddle, huh? Why would he be hiding from you? Okay, well, we'll do that, I guess. Mark that one off. You're going to want to go back to Wolong and talk to Ruidi. I don't think I have any items to pick up here. No. So let's keep going. We're looking for, I think, 3 more encounters. 1 desert, 2 grasslands. Wow, that was a quick encounter. Oh, we got undead. Good, this is one of the encounters that I want. This one has probably the least useful item that I can get. The night desert encounter with undead actually has something a little more useful. I was getting the two confused. Of course, since it's undead, getting Meteor Storm off is probably a good idea. You can also, I think you can trip undead, right? Oh yeah, yeah, you can trip undead. But really, you shouldn't have to, because with the undead, they're all weak to blunt. Yeah, look at the damage of those Debassers. That is awesome. So let's find this Katana of Skill. I think it's over here. Yep, there it is. It's not very useful, but it's there. Rosalind's getting hit by something. I have no idea what the hell is attacking her. What the hell is going on? Rosalind? Oh. Bone mages are attacking you? How is that guy meleeing her from across the wall? What the hell? That makes no sense.
Success.
That was really weird. And I get a second quilted holy robe? Really? Yeah, I don't know what that was about. That was weird. Why didn't you cast Vitalize? I told you to. Yeah, that was really weird. What the hell? Go for a trip. And a backstab. Guy was probably already almost dead, but whatever. Honestly, just tripping and letting the Debassers do the work is perfectly viable. We get a Katana of Skill. It is a two-handed weapon that ups your sword weapons by 1. I don't really like it. It is pretty fast, though, for a two-handed weapon, so I guess if you're using two-handed weapons, you could use that. I mean, it's faster than the shard sword, but I'd still probably use the heavier weapon, honestly. I mean, at this point, chain attacks aren't even that useful. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. That's the only item here. All of these undead enemies are the same as they were before. They're just higher level. They give really bad experience, too. Okay, let's keep going. Zigzag over here so I can get as much as possible. Liangshan's going to be right around here. Let's save so I don't have to get that encounter again. That undead encounter seems pretty rare to me, so... We're just looking for the Gamadi's Cloak encounter, and then there's another undead encounter in the desert. Well, here it is! The Gamadi's Cloak encounter. Awesome. Let's make a save here. I also want to farm a Torque of Haste from an Oni Mail here. Which I believe is the big ones. So I think I'll do that first. Yeah, we'll do that first because... Well, that's just a regular Oni. Actually, I think they're all called Onis. Oh no, that's an Oni Mage. I should summon the Celestial Samurai, but nah. Yeah, I don't even have to use Trip half the time now. Awesome. Yeah, those smaller ones are Oni Females. Those ones are Oni Males. But yes, the Torque of Haste, I want to farm. Just because it's useful for Jekhar, so it makes it easier for him to get overpower going. I don't know how Flece took so much damage there. It's kind of odd. Of course, she died. That's good. That was odd. I really don't know how she took so much damage. These guys hit harder than I remember them hitting. So hopefully I can get the item relatively quickly. Yeah, these three over here. Pretty much the three that I have farmed. You could get two of them, but I'm going to find something that's almost as good anyway. I'm not going to kill that mage guy. I'm just going to reload if I don't get it. And then I'll edit out until I do get the damn thing. You don't have to get this thing, but... Well, I want Jekhar to have some useful neck accessory. Damn it, he dropped an Orenian Saber. Of all the things to drop... Anyway, the Oni females are strong against Blunt. The Orenian males, or the Oni males, sorry, they are strong against Pierce. The Torque of Haste is a rare drop, but it's not that rare. And the Oni mage, they're also strong against Pierce. Ah, right, and they can drop Ring of Repulsions, which is a rare drop. I want those as well, but I find it easier to farm those in the next area. But if you get them... Awesome. How many do I need again? I forget. I want three of them, right. So if you can get some of those, great, but don't go out of your way yet. But I do want to get the Torque of Haste. So I'll be back once I get the Torque of Haste. Well, I already got it. Let's go ahead and equip that on Jekhar. His chain attacks are the most useful, so... I like to give him the Torque of Haste. Take a look at his speed stat now. Yeah, 112%. Not bad. I suppose I should actually show you what the Torque of Haste does, huh? It ups your speed plus 3, so... I don't know exactly how that factors into actually calculating your speed stat, but... Well, it's there. It makes it easier for him to hit the, well, what I care about, overpower. Of course, sometimes overpower doesn't work. Oh, I got a ring of repulsion. Awesome. That ups parry and counterattack by 3. It's very, very good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, instead of the ring of protection, I'm going to give that to Jekhar and give him the ring of repulsion. If I can find it. Gotta identify it. I'll want to get a couple more of those later on, but for right now, pretty good. I'll want one for Joseph eventually, when he doesn't need his summoning rings anymore. Because after you hit about 60,000 experience with each ring, you get the second summon. And at that point, you don't really need to have the summon equipped anymore, or the ring equipped anymore. So, all I have to do now is find a couple of items here. We're looking for a Gimati's Cloak, a Ring of Speed, and a Nobleman's Sabaton. There's a lot more mages in the next area, that's why I wait until then to farm it. Might be a good idea to silence those mages, they do hit pretty hard. It does work, but... there we go. Heal up Jekhar there. I think the Gamadi's Cloak is right over here. Maybe I should clear out all the enemies. I have no idea what the hell he was doing there. But, whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna clear out all the enemies and then I'll be right back. Okay, I took out all the enemies, so let's find the 3 items here. I thought for sure one of them was right here, but I could be wrong. No, that's just a rock. Apparently I forgot to kill one of the enemies. Well, there's a Ring of Speed. It upped your speed by 2. I'm not going to use it. Evidently, I didn't take these guys out. But that's alright. Yeah. Slow didn't really do anything to that guy. Slow is a weird status in this game. It only works when it feels like it. Even though it says it's working. Ah, there we go. I love those Debassers. They're awesome. So let's take a look for... the Gamadi's Cloak. Is it over here? Nope. Maybe it's in that forest where the other one was, the sparrow's egg. Nope. I know there's an item down here. Ah, the Nobleman's Sabaton. It's a better piece of leg gear for Joseph, so let's go ahead and equip it on him. It's equal to the Springsteel boots, but it gives you... what does it give you? Plus 10 AP, so... you might as well give it to him. Ah, here it is. And the Gimadi's Cloak, which is another plant, I believe. Yes. So we want to hand that in to, what was her name? I don't know. Nandi, I think. So when we get back around to, you know what? Let's save. When we get back around to, Wolong, I'll go back in, talk to Ruidi, and talk to Nandi. You okay? Gonna keep completing this map here. Now, the only thing is that I'm done with grasslands encounters, which is good and all, but that does mean that I'm kind of wasting my time now. That's all right. We're almost done. Of course, another encounter. Okay, let's keep going here. Now, that's Liangshan. If you get too close to it, just say no, don't enter it. You'll be okay. Alright, keep going. You don't have to complete the map again, but for some reason it really bothers me when the world map is not completed. I don't know why, it just does. Alright, keep going. Oh, now I gotta turn around, because I've missed some things over here. Can I walk through that water? I don't remember. I think so, yes. Can't get to Iona from here, by the way. I think that's the entire map. Yeah. I'm gonna save, because I don't want to lose that, that's for sure. So let's head on over to the desert and look for the final encounter that I need. It contains an accessory that I'd like to equip on Joseph. Not that great or anything, but it'll help him get some more experience for his summoning rings. It would be really nice if I could make it into that desert without a random encounter. I don't think that's close enough. Okay. Now we're going to the desert. So we're looking for a nighttime desert encounter with some undead enemies. Unfortunately, it's quite rare. I always have trouble getting it. But whatever. Let's just find the thing. Maybe this darker patch might be good to use or try on. Okay, I think I actually found the encounter relatively quickly. Oh, well, we got a burning bone knight here. That's a new enemy. I believe he's actually immune to fire. I'll just take him out. Yeah, he absorbs fire. He's strong against pierce and slash, but he is weak to ice. Take out this idiot. So, not a terrible idea to cast freeze or icicle on the Burning Bone Knight. Now, there's one other enemy here that is unique to this encounter called a mummy. They can inflict curse on you. If that happens, cure it immediately. Curse is not nice. I didn't actually want to do that. I wanted to heal Flece, but that's okay. The mummy is immune to energy, but weak to fire and ice. But it actually has pretty decent magic resistance. He's also guarding the item I want. Oop, I got hit with a curse there. So now the thing is that he doesn't actually inflict curse on you himself. Essentially what He does. Darn, I can't backstab him. Oh well. He automatically, like, counterattacks. Or, that's not really a counterattack. Effectively, every time you hit him, there's a chance that you'll get cursed. But anyway, we get the summoner's torque, which I'm going to go ahead and equip on Joseph. It'll up his summoning skill by 3, which will make him get more experience. For the rings there. And yeah, I got 3 torques of haste there. Pretty ridiculous. Let's go ahead and save so I don't have to do that again. Mark off this last one on my checklist. And I think that's all of them. Oops, I'm running into a wall. Yeah, that's it. So all I want to do now is get to Wolong, talk to Ruidi, and talk to Nandi. And I think that's it. Okay, so let's head down south. I think I'm going the right way. Yeah. Yeah, there's Wolong. Hopefully I can get around without another encounter. Not too far away. There we go. Now, if you're wondering how long this whole episode took me, about an hour and a half. So, yeah, hour and a half, 2 hours, that's about what it usually takes me. But anyway, I need a joke or a riddle. Sure, let's pay him the money. Pursued by death. Okay. Here comes the punchline. Punchline? Oh, it gets better. Okay. Oh, it's just a talking cat. That's not funny. Can I have the gold back? Okay. He'll die, huh? You're a sage of jokes, huh? That's very funny. Okay, dude. Get the point. What is your solution? Keep the cat from talking, huh? Well, that's not very nice. Okay, what are we gonna do? Okay. So, yeah, that's what we have to do. We have to get bark from the tree. Yay. And finally, talk to Nandi, hand in the Gamadi's cloak. I think that's a requirement for the third ingredient to appear. Give her the cloak. So we need Bane's Kiss, that's in Liangshan, which we're going next. Or Liangshan, or however you pronounce it. But for now... Oh, no, there's one other thing I can do. Jekhar hit level 18. Man, he's got a lot of points to work with. So at level 18 for Jekhar, I want to... Well, he learned the heal spell, or attribute. And I want to put 9 points into that immediately. Max that out. Having more heal spells is always good. I also want to give him counterattack plus 1. That'll get his counterattack up to 5. It's 8 with the Ring of Repulsion. And magic resistance plus 3. Which is very, very helpful for the upcoming area because of those Oni mages. And that'll do the trick. Let's take a look at what his magic resistance is now. 56, not bad. In fact, even Flece has 50% now. So yeah, magic is not too strong against us anymore. But yeah, it's time to end this episode. On the next episode, we will be heading into Liangshan. Unless I missed something on the world map, but I don't think so. So yeah, this is Ryzen. Thanks for watching. Take care.